there, I'm Tommy Ferris from Mission Fitness and welcome to another episode of MSCtv. Today I'm here to give you a few quick and easy tips for open water swimming at the Wasaga Beach Triathlon, but before we get to those, let's take a look at the course. Starting and finishing at the main beach area, the swim will be a water start and the course is triangular in shape. Keep the buoys to your left, sight often, and expect a bit of chop in the water as conditions in Georgian Bay can vary greatly from day to day. There are two different bike courses, and if you're doing the sprint triathlon or duathlon, you'll have a 10K out and back along River Road East and Eastdale Drive. If you're doing the full Olympic distance race, you'll be on a one loop course that starts with a very short out and back turnaround on Deerbrook Drive before returning to River Road East. And here the route hugs several kilometers along the shores of Georgian Bay. There are only a couple turns on this 40K course before making your way back to transition area. Both the sprint and Olympic distance races share the same run route. If you're a sprint distance athlete, you'll complete one loop along Beach Drive, Mossley Street, and a couple of smaller residential streets, and Olympic distance athletes will complete two loops before finishing in front of the transition area. What makes this race unique is that it's one of the only races in the Recharge with Milk Triathlon series that takes place on a large, open body of water, in this case, Georgian Bay. So on race morning, conditions may not be what you're used to. So what I'm going to go over today are a few tips for sighting in open water and how to deal with choppy swim conditions. Sighting in open water is always a bit trickier than in a pool. You can always swim with your head down when in the pool, but once in the open water, you'll have to pop your head up every few strokes to make sure you're not swimming off course. On a course like Wasaga Beach, you'll have to use the buoys to guide you when swimming away from shore, but once you've reached the first turn, you can pick a landmark on the horizon and use that as your sight line. I always find that sighting off a large landmark on shore is much easier than sighting off the buoy line because I don't have to bring my head out of the water as much to spot it, but sometimes you won't have a choice and sight often to stay straight. It helps if you know the course and are able to swim it ahead of time, so if you can fit in a swim at the race site in the lead up to the race, choose your sight lines then to give yourself an advantage on the morning of. To deal with choppy water, it's always best to make sure you practice swimming in rougher conditions ahead of time, so if there is some chop at the race, it's not your first time in those conditions. If the rougher water makes you uncomfortable, your priority is to make sure you get out of the water safely. Swim at the back of the pack and rest if you feel panicked. Swimming in choppy water also presents a new challenge to your breathing if you're only used to breathing on one side. If you're used to breathing on the right and the waves are coming in from the right, you're going to have to start breathing on your left. And an easy way to practice breathing on both sides is to pick one side of the pool deck and always breathe to that side in both lap directions. In the past, less than ideal water conditions in Georgian Bay have canceled the swim at the Wasaga Beach Triathlon, but luckily there's a backup swim location in the river on the opposite side of the race site. So no matter what the conditions are on race morning, you will be swimming. Well, that's going to do it for this episode of MSCtv, and coming up next, I'll be giving you some tips to cheat the wind at the Lakeside Triathlon. Thanks for watching.